A disturbing piece of news has appeared in the Voice of the Martyrs magazine. This news has been confirmed from several and varied sources. It focuses on China, about which I have spoken before. In the magazine, there was a half-page blurb about the CCP, the Chinese Communist Party, rewriting the Bible to make it more communist and less Christian. Here's an example. John 8:7 to 11 was rewritten to say, Jesus once said to the angry crowd who was trying to stone a woman who had sinned, "He who is without sin among you, let him cast a stone at her." When his words came to their ears, they stopped moving forward. When everyone went out, Jesus stoned the woman himself and said, "I am also a sinner." Now let's talk about this. Even in America, where there is an abundance of Bibles, people don't understand the Bible well. People have lots of false thinking and wrong ideas. Can you imagine in a country where the written word of God is much less available, but the government makes this version available to people? It's a diabolical, insidious strategy to corrupt Christianity. The clip from the magazine says that the revisions will include adding core socialist values and completely removing some passages that do not reflect communist beliefs. The Bible will be annotated with passages from Confucian, Taoist, and Buddhist classics. People won't even be able to tell what is the Word of God and what isn't. Now, it's bad enough that we can't trust the media, what we read in social media, politicians, statisticians, or even educators. But if we can't trust the Bible, a great foundation has been taken away. When the people of China get a real Bible and compare it to the CCP Bible, it could just lead to confusion and motivate them to reject it all. Another possibility is that it will lead to false teaching and corruption in the churches, as if we need that. Now, there isn't much we can do about this because it's mostly beyond our reach, but we can pray to God to disrupt the plan because it's not beyond God's reach. Another strategy is to make certain we know the Bible well because the Bible is being corrupted here as well. Let me give you a few examples. I've been asked many times to clarify the Bible's position on LGBTQ because people have read in numerous places that the texts about homosexuality that we have been changed from their originals. Yeah. I am repeatedly told that omnipotence means God should be able to do anything, even contradict himself or act in a contrary way to his character. I am often told the Gospels have no practical historical connection to Jesus and that they were written so long after his death that they can't be trusted in any capacity. In other words, the same thing is happening here in the U.S., but the government doesn't even need to print a corrupted version. Americans are getting that from their neighbors, their teachers, and the internet. We better make sure we know our Bibles, because we are on the same road.